America's auto industry is at a new crossroad. GM has been rocked by a recall scandal, and a new generation is moving in at Ford. CEO Alan Mulally hands over the keys to his successor, Mark Fields, on July 1st. Company chairman Bill Ford handpicked Mulally to lead the automaker 8 years ago. Since then, Ford has gone from $23 billion in losses to $43 billion in profits. Alan Mulally is here in Studio 57. Welcome.
Hi, Charlie. Hi, Nora.
There's much to talk about, but first, General Motors. I mean, tell me how you see their problems and what you would do if you were running that auto company.
Well, Charlie, clearly, I'm not at General Motors, but I can sure give you my perspective representing Ford. And I think the most important thing that drives us is the focus on the customer, continually understand everything about our products, and anytime we see an issue, then we move decisively to do the right thing for the customer.
But wouldn't GM have that? I mean, don't they have that same sense?
Well, in Ford's case, you know, we are set up and organized where we have businesses around the world, but we also have skill teams like engineering and manufacturing that go across the world. So we have tremendous visibility and insight into the status of the
vehicles. How do you find responsibility, though? I mean, if I'm a CEO, I want to know how something like this could happen and make sure I act in the right way.
Oh, Charlie, absolutely. And our whole process is based on safe and efficient transportation. So everybody,
saying this couldn't happen at Ford?
Well, you always want to be really humble.
Because you've had your own problems in the past.
Absolutely. And so the most important thing is to create a culture where everybody knows what the status is and everybody knows the areas that need special attention. And I'm very proud about
Ford. But I get the impression the new CEO is trying to do just that.
Well, I'm sure she is. It's so important for the industry that that we all take responsibility for safe and efficient transportation.
I guess just as a CEO, what we're curious about, you know, because I read this report, a decade long of negligence across all parts of the company. How does something like that happen? I mean, that's pretty widespread.
Well, clearly, I can only speak for Ford. And all I know is, as you pointed out in your opening remarks, is for 8 years, we've pulled together as a team around a compelling vision of Henry Ford's original vision of safe and efficient transportation. Mm-hmm. We have everybody on the team. Okay, everybody's so
here's
there
what
every Thursday.
Here's what I hear you saying. I'm not going to criticize General Motors. I'm only going to tell you what happens at Ford.
Absolutely. That's what I know, and I'm so proud of the way Ford takes care of our customers and deals decisively with issues that when they come up.
Tell me what you think of Elon Musk and Tesla.
Well, I think Elon has a very interesting business proposition with Tesla. What he focused on was really the high end of the luxury market with an all-electric vehicle. And now he's trying, like all of us, to democratize electric vehicles. We have, in Ford, tremendous electric vehicles on the smaller size. What his unique proposition was that he has a battery that's big enough that removes a lot of the range anxiety. But, of course, these batteries are $60,000 or $70,000, so it's a limited market for the vehicle. But we are absolutely, like Elon, dedicated to improving the battery and the cost effectiveness so we can bring electric vehicles.
But has he made the other automakers more competitive? Has he pushed them because he was willing to get out there?
Well, I think
and attract attention for what he's doing, and the market, certainly the stock market, has responded.
Well, Charlie, I think that's an important part about electric vehicles because there is a lot more awareness now of the value of electric vehicles, but also what the challenges are to have them be affordable because Henry Ford and Ford have always wanted to make it available for everybody. So the really key thing is to work on the enabling technology to get the cost of the batteries to be more effective.
You wonder, though, if there's been enough urgency about this.
Well, it's interesting because Henry Ford was very good friends with Thomas Edison at the turn of the century. And at that time, all the vehicles that Ford had were electric. So we've been dedicated to figuring this out for, 111 years. So we're going to figure it out, but it's going to be a new chemistry probably for the batteries.
When will that happen?
I think over the next few years.
You had massive losses at Ford. You turned that around to big profits. And you talk about changing the culture of a company. How do you change the culture of a company or business?
Well, I think, you reported the story where when I first arrived, it was hard to get good visibility into what the real status was, and everybody wasn't on the team. So I think the most important thing is to come together and have everybody on the team agree to a compelling vision about what the Ford brand was going to stand for: quality, fuel efficiency, safety, a complete family. And then we implemented a management system, as you know, that every Thursday worldwide we sit down together and review every aspect of the business, all the new vehicles, all the launches. So there's this tremendous transparency and accountability for knowing what the status is. We also color code all the issues too, so the reds, the yellows, the greens.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you're giving everybody out this card now that says One Ford, that lays out exactly what are the vision and the values of your company.
Nora, this is absolutely been a huge change for us because we laid out the plan, profitable growth for all, make the best cars and trucks in the world, do it more efficiently than our competition. But to your point, we actually laid out the expected behaviors about technical excellence and working together and also our values and delivering results. And we are absolutely committed to these behaviors.
I mean, the big thing you did, you went out and borrowed a lot of money so that you didn't need support from the government when the time came.
We did take out a small
home
improvement
loan. Needed.
Yeah, it was a small,
how much was it?
$23.5 billion.
Yeah.
And at the time, we did that because we wanted to restructure the business to get back to profitability, but also invest in the new products.
You are one of the most recognized CEOs in the world. And you've had two very successful reigns as a CEO at two very different companies. So what next for you?
Well, I haven't been thinking about that so much because, Charlie, I've been really focused on this orderly transition at Ford. It's very rare in business, as you know, to have an orderly transition. So we have a great team. Mark Fields is going to be a terrific CEO, but we have one of the strongest teams I've ever had the honor of helping pull together. But also, the commitment to the strategy, to the management system, to this culture of working together. So I think that's the most important thing I've been focused on. But I'm looking forward to the future.
And got a lot. Go ahead.
Have you been approached about leading the VA at all?
I am really looking forward to figuring out what the future is going to
be. Sounds like an evasion to me, doesn't it?
Yeah. What is something you might consider?
Well, I've really been focused on this transition to Ford, but I am looking forward to
So when will you decide what you're going to do next?
Well, I officially retire on July 1st, and the team is ready to go. They're in great shape, and I'm looking forward to what the future will bring.
Alan Mulally, great to have you here. Good luck. Let us know what your next move is.
Absolutely. Thanks a lot. Thanks for covering the transformation, too.
Thank you.